Hi, I'm Mary Wong. Today I have Heller Rush Hardy, the organizer of Commonwealth Classics, to join us to share about the competition. So tell us why you named it Commonwealth Classic.
So I am co-organizing the Commonwealth Classic. And when Andrew and I took the competition over, it was already called the Commonwealth Classic. It actually had 30 year anniversary just before we took it over, I think, or maybe the year. No, I think we took it over the year after. I'm not sure. So it's been a comp that's been around for a long time. And I remember when I first came to Boston as a professional, I actually danced in the Commonwealth Classic as a professional.
Wow, it means a long history of it.
It was one of those, you know, because I'm situated in Boston myself. It was one of those comps we did every year because they were local, and it had a very nice, it was always a comp that had a very nice feel to it. It was very, everybody knew everybody. Everybody was not, I mean, I'm sure that's the same in all competitions, but you know, it wasn't like humongous and you know, it was just one of those local comps that every year we knew, okay, we come to the first weekend of November, we're going to do the Commonwealth Classic. It was like, we knew that. So when Andrew and I took it over, we just thought the name was just so fitting for the
classic.
So long. So we kept the name and we just kind of upgraded the logo a little bit. We kept even the color scheme. It was like sort of the navy blue. We kept that. We added some gold to it. So we made it, we feel, a little bit more luxury. I don't know, you know, like we just gave it a little bit of a facelift, you know, and but we're still in the same hotel where the comp was happening a few years before we took it over. So we kind of left.
The hotel is in Burlington.
Yeah,
Marriott, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, which is actually a very great spot. I mean, it's not center Boston, but it's close enough. It's not a long drive if people are coming in from the airport or if you're driving up from, you know, New York or whatever. But it offers like a really nice restaurant. And then just down the street from the hotel, there's a bunch of restaurants and mall and stuff. So it's in actually a very good area. Free parking, which is important.
Totally. And for me, I always go and I even compete there as well. So for me, actually, it's also a great come to prep for Ohio because it's the right before Harrow as well. So I love it that people are so friendly, and you know, that's why I'm going there. So definitely well recommended.
That's actually a very big point, and I forgot that, Irene, that even when I was competing with some of my, you know, top level pro-am guys, we would use the Commonwealth as a warm-up for Ohio Star Bowl. Yeah. So that is because it was still, you know, it was close, but not the weekend before Ohio Star Bowl. I think we're 2 weeks out or something, you know. So we're always the first weekend of November. And then obviously Ohio Star Bowl is right before Thanksgiving, right?
So right. So that's why I'm always pick Commonwealth, almost always come pick Commonwealth as my prep to Ohio Star, because it's 2-3 weeks. So we can prep it and see anything, the minor tweak that we need to do, and then go for Ohio.
Exactly. Yeah. So, and that's what I did myself too, when I was still in it to win it.
That's wonderful. Thank you so much.